that we have made everything positive thing, quality information, the assessment of which priority assignments. Okay, so wikis are well-known tools. We also know them because of Wikipedia and other projects. They foster open collaboration, and they also foster and can apply students to use writing skills, critical analysis, and open collaboration among others inside the group or outside the group in the private spaces. The point is, wiki register the data of every contribution, every atomic contribution made to the wiki, and it's publicly available for everyone participating in experience. So we have a lot of data to apply learning analytic techniques, but it's an scalability issue when you want to make a detailed assessment, because when you the more students you have, the higher pace the number of interaction grows. It's a problem of scalability. So we made different items. This was the first approach we made. It was a quantitative approach. We made some briefing with rankings of students who edited more times a week, more often, the number of editions in the articles, the weight, the number of bytes or letters, charts, whatever you want, modifying the articles. And we made some rankings and some kind of heat map report showing how they work more or less in the pages, in the own pages, in other people's pages and so. We also made a timeline analysis, again quantitative. This was, for example, a typical chart of a student who only worked before the deadlines in the milestone. They have to make an initial contribution to the project here, and he made it the night before, then here, and then the last part of the project. And this was a collaborative chart showing how different students contributed to the overall of the project. There is a clear leader in blue color, because he was the only one who write everything in the week in the start. Then the green one collaborated, and then red student joined. And at the end, we have almost one third of the global content made by everyone. So we got information, interesting, evidence-based, and scalable. But what about the content? We got our feedback, and the guy said, okay, these are evidences that you cannot discuss, but there is information that you have to analyze. Okay, so we created a qualitative system for the assessment, and it was using a rubric that the students make not on the final state of the page, but on single editions made by different students. So they could assess each other in a peer review, and then if they did not agree with the review, they could tell the supervisor to check if it was okay or not, and correct it in case it had to be modified. It was scalable in the meaning that they were the students who made the assessment, one to another. They were made on evidences, on simple anatomic contributions, and this was the state of the wiki page before that date, and that was after this student made the contribution. But then we had a problem. The process was scalable only in the meaning of doing the assessment, but not in the case of analyzing the data. Okay, so we made a mix of both approaches. We had the initial charts, we had quantitative, and then we made a software to enrich that information with the information from different skills that the students had their access. So we have here a richer graphics that somehow help the assessment process. Okay. And we can discuss the conclusion, but it helped in the assessment process.